Alrighty, here we are at round one, game one. We're on the die roll, so I'm going to choose to draw because it's vitally important that I hit on my land drops. And yeah, this is going to be a fine one. Turn two mare, even on the draw, should be pretty nice. I mean, just not play anything on my turn three, and then should start churning out some wolves if my opponent doesn't have removal. Otherwise, I got deadweight backup and rage thrower. It's going to be pretty important to strategies that don't involve just killing with mare. Alrighty, scourge at five if I can get another red. See how that goes. Red, blue, huh? Alrighty, well, we're gonna go with a mare here. Get my threat out, see how that goes. Any removals? Kessig Wolf, okay. So, by all means, I could, cast Disciple or Deadweight on. Disciple doesn't really do anything. Deadweight would kill the Kessig Wolf, or I could just let Mare flip. So let's just go with that. Now it really demands a removal spell. And I can certainly afford to take a hit here for three. Adding Disciple doesn't really contribute a lot. But I've already got, even if this Howl Pack doesn't work out, I've already got Disciple plus a Rage Thrower. Then I'll just need is a few dudes. Alrighty. Yeah, I think this I think this is definitely gonna work out. Oh my goodness. So, Howl Pack is live, churning out three threes. I've also got Bloodkeeper. So the question is, how much damage do I want to take in the meantime? Because I can, by all means, deadweight the Moon Heron here. We can deadweight the Moon Heron, attack for three, and then play Disciple of Grizzlebrand. I think that might be better than playing Bloodline Keeper. In fact, means I'm not taking as much damage, and I'm still getting damage in as well. So that would be one way for me to get blown out, is to recklessly take too much damage and then have. Oh no. I just played two spells, didn't I? Jeez, I'm a chump. Why did I play the Disciple? Oh, so bad. Well, that's one way to not rely on not rely on your bombs, just completely make them irrelevant. Bizarre. All right, now he's gone too. Whereas my opponent would have had to work a lot harder at killing him. Oh, jeez. I'll just put this down to me having too many good options here. 'Cause that was super loose. Should have just not played Disciple and kept Mare as a Howl Pack. So, does Wolf attack here? Surely not. There's a removal spell. Oh, he does. All right. Don't want to get hit with a Geist Flame here. I guess I'll take three. Pitchburn Devils. Okay. Can definitely take down my Rage Thrower. So, take down my Scourge, sorry. So, what's the attacks here? Just Scourge, I think. If my opponent wants to block with Pitch Burn and then sacrifice, yeah, block and then deal damage, I'll sacrifice and gain four here. This Bloodline Keeper. Man, this is pretty embarrassing. I mean, draw so well that I can play so loose. And as soon as I've got Rage Throw going here, yeah, sure, I'll take another three. I think I can afford to take hits with Disciple. Disciple should gain me plenty of life if I need it. Battleground Geist, okay. Still a mana away. I guess Abattoir Ghoul is fine. Yeah, Abattoir Ghoul. And pass. Start churning out, Start churning out vampires, 2/2 vampires. Would really like to see my 6 land so I can get Rage Thrower online and then just kill my opponent. So, if I go turn 6 Rage Thrower, then I can use all my mana, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I can nearly just kill my opponent by throwing every creature I control at him. That'd be pretty cool. Just the Battleground Geist. Again, I think I can afford to take it with Disciple. There's no tricks that are going to blow me out when I can gain life on a whim. Ludovic's Test Subject. Interesting. Still can't manage the 6th land. Well... So Ludovic's Subject is going to be 13-13 next turn. So I'm probably going to have to gain some life. So all I need to do... So 13's coming at me. 13... So I'll probably block Battleground Geist with a vampire. And I sacrifice that for 2. Puts me at... 2 puts me at 11. So much easier if I just got to my 6 land. So I just need to survive next turn, not die this turn. I'm attacking for... Whenever a creature dealt damage this turn dies, you gain life. So attack with Abattoir Ghoul Vampire, leaving back Bloodline Keeper and Wolf. Five. So if I'm attacking for 5, my opponent doesn't block. I'm gonna die to Subject alone. If I play Night Revelers, that's 4 I put in front of the Test Subject. Two needs 5. Counters. So 1, 2 and end of turn, and then 1, 1, 2, 3. So I can attack with Disciple. Disciple could also block Kessig Wolf next turn. Markov Patrician gains me life as well. So as long as Markov Patrician isn't blocking Kessig Wolf, Markov Patrician gains me 4. 4, I block Battleground Geist, I block Kessig Wolf with my Wolf, say. So, 4, I sacrifice the Vampire blocking the Battleground Geist. That's 6. I'm preventing from 13, 7, so I think, yeah, alright, Markov Patrician will keep me alive. And I can attack with these guys. And disciple. No, I need disciple next turn. So, pretty sure I survive. Do I kill on the backswing though? That's the question. I have to get through 9? Not quite. Though if I'm not dying, I take 5, and then I can bash with Bloodline Keeper as well, so that's 5, 6, 7, 8. 8. Maybe just keep Disciple. Make sure Disciple isn't blocking. Think it works. Opponent's used up all his mana, so I can kill Cassock Wolf, that helps. Is Cassock Wolf not attacking? If Cassock Wolf isn't attacking, I don't think I even need to block Battleground Geist. So, probably best that I do anyways. So I make a 2/2. I block 2. Alright, so I'm preventing all from Battleground Geist, 3 from Ludovic's test subject plus another 3 I get from Lifelink. So he's dealing 7, so I'm going to go to 2, I don't need to sacrifice anything. Otherwise, otherwise I could put... No, that seems good. Then next turn I attack for 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. My opponent blocks Abattoir Ghoul. And I get in for 5, 6, not enough. Awkward. Not gonna kill next turn. What if I kept Vampire? What if I kept Vampire? So I need 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, I gotta put Vampire there, I think. Alright, deal the damage. So I'm going to 2. Okay. Now I get to 6. So is there a way to stop myself from dying while I can get Rage Thrower online? So my opponent has to block Abattoir Ghoul. If I attack a 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If I attack with everything, my opponent has to block Abattoir Ghoul, which means I gain 3. Oh, hang on. If I play Rage Thrower, he has to block, and then at least one creature is going to the graveyard, which is going to get another 2 damage through. So I've got 2. So 5, 6. Oh, I could get 8 damage through. If I play Rage Thrower and he blocks Abattoir Ghoul, he takes 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Takes 8. Crap. that's not what I wanted to hear. Otherwise, how much toughness have I got to block with? I can block Battleground Geist, and I've got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, not anywhere near enough. I guess. Guess my best out is to play Rage Thrower and attack. This is so bad. I shouldn't even be in this situation. My own fault. He blocks Abattoir Ghoul, takes 2. Oh, no, they don't trade. Yeah. Blocks Abattoir Ghoul, takes 2, and goes to 1. Now I go to 5. We'll see. Yep. Well, that was good. Play like a chump, get smashed by Ludovic's Abomination. Yeah, good times. Well, don't have any changes to make, I don't think. Let's continue on. Alright, round 1, game 2. Again, we're going to choose to draw, because we really need to get to 6. It all happens when Rage Thrower hits the table. Alright, this hand is perfectly acceptable. Let's go to 2, 3, and 6. Hopefully we don't miss out on 6 this time. And hopefully I don't play as badly this time. Alright. Getting there. Guy Sketcher's Rig should be pretty potent. I did see a number of flyers. Yeah. What are the chances of me seeing my forest with Mare again? Nothing at 3, you say? Brimstone Volley is a really good one. Let's get in for 1 here. And wolf it up. Alrighty, so just want to see 2 lands off the top. Forbidden Alchemy. Alrighty. Anything relevant to the graveyard? Ooh, did not choose Ludovic's test subject. Chose something else. Okay. Not great in the early game, obviously. Still fine though. Moonheron, sure. Guess I can hold out till 6 for that guy. Ooh, no land off the top. That makes me sad. Think I can hold on to Brimstone Volley. Especially with a Disciple out. It's a guaranteed 5, so good value. Plus, once I get to 6, so on the draw with 18 lands, I should be able to get my 6 land by turn 6, right? Surely. What's next? Pitchburn Devils, you say? Okay. Missing land drops? Seriously? with all the lands I'm playing? If I attack, just get attacked back. I think that's okay. Not great, but okay. Maybe a Brimstone Volley now? It'd be really nice to wait till Rage Thrower is out. Plus, I only need two lands for Geist Catcher. I'm gonna take six now. Brimstone Volley. Gonna take too many hits waiting to get to six, unfortunately. Missing land drops? Maybe just up the land count to 20. That should do it. Alright, so in comes Pitchburn Devils. Go ahead. Rage Thrower should make a race favorable. Battleground Geist, okay. So there's another Geist Catcher for your Geist. Land? It's not a land. That's alright, we're attacking for three, and we still get Abattoir Ghouls for value. But seriously, where are my lands at? When I've got the deck that gets turned on when it gets to six, and I can't even get to six. Oh man, Rolling Trembler. Well, that was a blowout. Yeah, that was bad. Land off the top? Okay, okay. Can we stabilize with... Let's see. Scourge is big, but just trades with Pitchburn Devils. I think I'd rather have Pitchburn Devils, to be honest. Unfortunately, lost my life gain mechanic. So, gonna take our grasp. All right. Well, that's the end. Let's just pretend like it never happened. All right. Yeah.